Yep. In our previous section, we have created two projects, one in ASP.NET and another one in ASP.NET Core. So let's open both the projects side by side to compare the folder structure of both the application. You can see there are many more folders available in root of older ASP.NET version, while there are very few folders available in root of ASP.NET Core. Let's have a look at the default files and folders created by Visual Studio in older ASP.NET project and understand the importance of those. Also, we will understand what has changed in ASP.NET Core corresponding to each file and folder. So, first one is app data. New projects often begin with an empty app data folder. This is where you can place database files. This folder no longer created in ASP.NET Core by default, but if needed, you can create the same manually. Second one is app start. This is a folder which contains various classes which are called when our application starts. So let's understand the purpose of each file in this folder. So first file is bundle config. This file allows programmer to specify the CSS and JS file which you want to add to bundling. If you are not aware of what the bundling is, I would like to tell you that bundling is a feature that was introduced in ASP.NET 4.5 that helps to boost the performance of your application by combining or bundling multiple files into a single minified files. So fewer files means fewer HTTP requests, and that can improve the performance of your web application drastically. You can bundle CSS, JavaScript, and other files using this class to combine all into a single file. So you can see that in Core, there is no such files available. So unfortunately, bundling and minifications no longer exists in MVC Core by default. But don't worry, you can do that manually if needed. I am providing the link to the document that will guide you on how you can do that in ASP.NET Core in below link. Second one is filter config. ASP.NET MVC filters are used to inject extra logic at the different levels of MVC framework request processing. Filters provides a way to add filter in request pipeline so that all the requests pass through with those filters. The ASP.NET MVC framework supports various types of filtering like authentication, authorization, action, results, and exception. Each filter allows you to introduce custom logic at different points during request processing. As this file is no longer exist in ASP.NET Core, all of these filters can be added using configure service method available in startup class now. Third one is root config. So what does this file do? Routing functionality actually is responsible for mapping an incoming request to a root handler. Routes are defined in the application and configured when the application starts. We'll understand it in depth later in this course. In this section, it is sufficient to know that ASP.NET MVC routing is used to map the URL coming through browser to the specific controller class and action. If that controller and action is matched, it will be executed and page will be rendered. If it is not matched, 404 error is returned. Next one is public assets. In your application, there are public assets like images, CSS, fonts, and JavaScript files. In older ASP.NET version, all of these public assets were stored in root of your web application. But now, all of these public assets are moved to the www root folder. In older approach, there was an issue that if you had to exclude any of these public folders, you had to blacklist that folder from your application. But now, ASP.NET Core took a different approach. where application root is blacklisted and www root is whitelisted. With this approach, the chances of something private accidentally exposed outside is reduced. This is really a nice separation. So these are the folders which contains public assets are now moved to the www root. Let's understand what each folder contains. First one is content. It contains CSS, images, and other client-side assets. By default, Visual Studio places few files like Bootstrap, CSS, and site.css already in this folder. Second one is fonts. This folder exists is because Bootstrap is included in MVC by default. And that is probably also the reason that the naming convention of this folder does not match with the rest of the solution. You can see F is not capitalized. Third one is scripts. As its name suggests, it contains usually JavaScript files. And last one is fav icon. This is the icon which is displayed on the browser tabs. You can see the small icons that is displayed using fav icon files only. Next are controllers, models, and views. There is no change in ASP.NET Core and older version of ASP.NET. All these folders are same. So let's understand what these folders contains. First one is controller. Controller are responsible for controlling the flow of your application. When you request a page on browser in MVC application, a controller is responsible for returning the response to that request. Second one is model. All of your domain models will be placed here. The model represents the data and does nothing else. We have view folder which contains the classes responsible to create the user interface of your web application. And interestingly, views folders include separate folder for each controller with exact same name without suffixing controller in the folder name. Let's expand the controller folder and see, we do have exactly the folder with same name corresponding to the controller class. In addition to these folders, we have shared folder which contains the views that will be shared among different controllers, for example, layout file. Additionally, MVC projects also includes various configuration files. This is global.asx. This is one of the traditional file which is there in ASP.NET since long time. This file allows us to write the codes which can be executed in response of various application level events like application start, session end, etc. From ASP.NET Core, global.asx file has been removed completely and introduced startup.css as a replacement of global.asx. This one is packages.config. This file is managed by NuGet manager in order to maintain the list of packages referenced by the project. This allows NuGet to easily restore the project's dependency when the project is transported to the different machines such as build server, staging, and testing machine. NuGet package manager automatically downloads the required library from the central repository. Let's take a look at this file. You can see it contains the references to the various library with their version names. In .NET Core, this file does not exist. Packages are declared inside the CS project file. You can open that file by right-clicking the project and edit the CS project file. You can see package references are there in item group section. Next file is startup.cs. In ASP.NET 5, startup.cs file has introduced, and as mentioned earlier, this file is the replacement of global.asx. You can see from ASP.NET core, global.asx file has been removed completely. So all the works which were done in global.asx are now can be done using the startup.cs. And finally, we have webconfig file, which is an XML file which is used for the application level configuration. Most of time you work with only two sections in this file. One is connection string, which is used to define the database connection of your application. Second one is app setting, which is where we define our application setting in key value pairs. ASP.NET Core have introduced a new file called appsetting.json as the replacement of this for application setting configuration. And web config file is automatically generated when you publish the application. You can see there is program.cs available in ASP.NET Core. If you have worked on console application in C#, this file looks familiar to you. This is entry point of your application, and now ASP.NET Core application starts as a console application. The main method is responsible to create your web host. It invokes the webhost.createDefaultBuilder method, which defines the web server and startup class. Build and run methods builds the iWebhost object that hosts the application and begins listening for the HTTP requests. So our development environment is ready, and you are now familiar with the files and folder structure of the ASP.NET Core. Next, we are going to visit our bike project requirement and get ready for the first challenge.